In this video, I'm going to show you all 23 Fitbit Charge 5 clock faces that are available at the time of launch. I'll be showing how the clock faces look on the Fitbit Charge 5 display, as well as just showing you any interactivity and which stats are displayed. Alright, this face is called Continuum, and at the top here we have the month and day of month in numerical format. We have the time, just hours and minutes, no seconds, and we have a stat here that can change based on when we tap, and we have a little progress bar indicator that is based on your personal goal for that activity metric. So here we have active zone minutes, steps, heart rate, total calories burned, distance, and we're back to active zone minutes. All right, this clock face is called Intersection, and it is an analog clock face. So here's the time in a unique analog format. It does look like it shows seconds bar here. We have the date with the month written out and the day of month in numerical format. And then we have a changeable activity stat up here. So this is active zone minutes. We can tap to get steps, heart rate, total calories burned, distance, and we're back to active zone minutes. Alright, this clock face is called Zones, and it's a little bit different because the active zone minutes is the stat that is always visible along with the time. No seconds here on the time. So this stat here will change. We have steps. If we tap, we can get heart rate, total calories burned, distance, and we can have the date with the month written out in abbreviated form, as well as the day of the month. And then we're back to steps. Alright, this clock face is called Vogue, and it always shows the time without seconds, and then we can tap to scroll through active zone minutes, steps, heart rate, and back to active zone minutes. This clock face is called Energy, and we have the date, including the day of the week, we have the time, and we have a switchable stat here. So this is active zone minutes, steps, heart rate, total calories burned, and distance. And you'll also see here that there is a little progress circle that fills up as you get closer to your goals. So like the total calories burned is almost full. And then there's also some indication of, I'm assuming, seconds here, but it's not exactly every second that it turns, so. All right, this clock face is called Target, and it has the date with day of week and abbreviated month on the top. We have a hours and minutes, but no seconds. We have a tappable different stat here, and it also gives a progress bar for the stat. So this is active zone minutes, heart rate, steps, distance, and total calories burned. All right, this clock face is called Ripple, and we have the day of week and month and day of month here on the top, and the time, no seconds. We also have a changeable stat with a little circular progress, I guess progress circle. So we have active zone minutes, steps, heart rate, total calories burned, distance, and back to active zone minutes. All right, this clock face is called Run Liner, and we have the month and day of month here with the hours and minutes, no seconds. We have a heart rate number stat here, and then we have just progress bar indicators for active zone minutes, steps, and distance. So if you tap on this, nothing happens. This one is not interactive. This clock face is called Symphony. It is an analog clock face that does not have the date and does not appear to have seconds either. It does have a switchable stat for active zone minutes, steps, and heart rate. That's it. All right, this clock face is called Slashed. We have the day of week, month, and date of month. We have the hours and minutes, no seconds. And this one's a little different. We have three stats shown at a time. We have active zone minutes and steps are together here with heart rate. And if we tap once, we still have heart rate, but the top two stats were changed to total calories burned and distance. We also have a linear progress bar here for the top two stats. This face is called Retro. We have the day of week, month, and day of month. We have the hours and minutes, no seconds. We have a single stat here on the bottom with a little progress bar. So we have steps, heart rate, total calories burned, distance, active zone minutes, and we're back to steps. All right, this clock face is called progressive. We have the day of week, month, and day of month on the top. We have hours and minutes, no seconds, and we have switchable stat on the bottom, and we have active zone minutes, steps, heart rate, total calories burned, and it looks like this clock here also is a progress bar, so the yellow means you've filled it up almost all the way. And then here we have distance, and you can see here the purple is mostly, or pink is mostly there because the distance is not close to the goal. And then we're back to active zone minutes. This clock face is called Neo Flip. We have the day of week and day of month at the top here. We have kind of a cutoff hours and minutes here, and we have a switchable stat at the bottom. This one is active zone minutes. And here we have steps, which changes the color to green, heart rate, which is red, total calories burned, which is a teal blue, distance, which is yellow, and we're back to the orange active zone minutes. This is Hawaiian Punch. We have a hours, minutes, as well as seconds, and here is a switchable stat, and we have month and day of month, active zone minutes, steps, heart rate, total calories burned, distance, and we're back to the date. This is called Triangulate. We have the hours and minutes along with the month and day of month, and we have a switchable stat here at the bottom, so this is active zone minutes, and we have steps, and it changes the color to a green color, heart rate is red, total calories burned is teal, distance is a gold, and back to orange active zone minutes. All right, this one's called Split, and we have an outlined hours and minutes, no seconds, and we have a tappable stat here, so we have active zone minutes, steps, heart rate, total calories burned, distance, and we do have the month and day of month, and we're back to active zone minutes. This clock face is called California Dream. It's an analog clock face with a seconds hand. We have a abbreviated day of week and day of month. And we have a tappable stat here that can be, as you see, covered up. So we have active zone minutes, heart rate, and I guess that's it. Active zone minutes and heart rate. All right, this is Hexa. We have the month and day of month with hours and minutes, no seconds. We have active zone minutes, and we have steps, which just kind of changes the color here to blue. We have heart rate is red. Total calories burned is teal, and that does actually act as a progress bar. And then total distance, and back to active zone minutes. All right, this is Retro Flip, and we have month and day of month at the top here with hours and minutes, no seconds. And we have a changeable stat here, so we have active zone minutes, we have steps in teal, heart rate in red, total calories burned in blue, distance in gold, and we're back to the orange active zone minutes. All right, we've got a unique one here. It's called Tracks, and this in the background is actually the date. So we have September 28th. This is not the time. The time is actually analog, and it does have a seconds hand. But if you tap on the screen, the time actually goes away, and we get a colorful active zone minutes in blue, steps, heart rate in red, and we're back to the time in green. All right, this is Cutout. We have the day of the month and the abbreviated month, as well as hours and minutes a little bit cut off here. And then we have a switchable stat here in a different color on the bottom. So we have orange active zone minutes. Then we have green steps, red heart rate, blue calories burned, and yellow distance. And then we're back to zone minutes. This clock face is called Ice Cream, and it has no interaction at all. And no, my camera is not blurry. The text here is actually blurry on purpose. So we have the day of week and date of the month. We have a progress circle here for your step goal. And we have the hours and minutes of the time. All right, this clock face is called Stat Poster, and it's pretty modern. We have the hours, minutes, and seconds digitally here. We have the abbreviated month and the date of the month. And then we have a tappable stat. So you'll see here in the background it says AZM. That stands for active zone minutes. So this is your active zone minutes in orange. And if we tap, we get steps in green. We have BPM, heart rate, in red. And calories in blue. And distance in yellow. So pretty modern, unique clock face here. So those were all the Fitbit Charge 5 clock faces demonstrated for you on the watch itself. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up down below and consider subscribing if you want to see more Fitbit Charge 5 videos. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.